Okay, so this is the Cadillac Truth, what is it called? Truth and Dare test drive event, and it's at Citi Field. As you can see, that's Citi Field. So they've got pretty much every vehicle you could possibly expect to have right here. And they've got this new XT5, they've got the ESCALADE, they've got the CTS, they got the XTS, they got it all. And basically, Cadillac, they need to do things just like this because ultimately, they need to show off their cars. Like, this is the XTS right here. That's probably my favorite. I mean, the CT6 is a lot bigger, a lot longer. The thing about it is the CT6 is, it's a little bit too big. Hey, the guy basically told me that I have to go to a different gate because the parking's on a different side. As you can see, they've got like a huge road course right here, all built up and ready to go. And as you can see, they have the CT6, CTS-V, ATS-V, etc., etc., etc. So they got it all right here. Okay? So this is gonna be an interesting day. I'm gonna try to make two different videos, one 4K quality, and one I'm gonna do on Facebook Live, so that this way I can, you know, be a live tweeter. But I gotta go to the different side gate. Okay, so I've changed to the opposite lot. So this is lot G. And I gotta just figure out the way in there. And all good. I don't know anything about baseball, but I'm wearing a Yankee shirt, so they probably think I do know a lot about baseball, which I don't. I don't follow baseball. I can't name a single person on the Yankees. I can't name a single person on the Mets. I don't even know what the names of the stadiums are, honestly. This is probably my first time here since they called it Citi Field. I'm just not into baseball. Sorry, you're just gonna have to criticize me for that. Okay, so everybody's walking back towards... Hey, this guy must be a player. He was dressed like something. Dressed like a shortstop or something like that. 99. You know, I really feel bad because I might be walking past, what is it called? I might be walking past celebrities and I never know. Like, they got numbers on and everything. I'd be walking right past a celebrity and not know it. Oh well. You know? I don't watch baseball, I don't watch basketball, I don't watch football, I don't watch soccer. I'm too busy making money. You know, they don't send me checks. I gotta make my own checks. Okay, so they got a nice ambulance. And I'll tell you, these test drive events, even though these things are relatively safe and they're controlled, simple fact of the matter is there's still danger involved, because when I was at the S.R.T. track experience, you know, we had Dodge Chargers and Dodge Challengers. Sometimes those things would jump in the track and they'd end up, you know, they'd end up on the wrong side of the track, and it's very easy to have an accident. Okay, so we got an ESCALADE here. This is an ATS-V, CTS-V, there we go. There we go, CTS-V. I made a video about the CTS-V and a lot of people were very angry at me because I said it wasn't shit compared to the Hellcat. Oh well, you're just gonna have to be upset because it ain't shit compared to the Hellcat. I don't give a goddamn how much it costs. The simple fact of the matter is, Hellcat got 707. I can't even tell you off the top of my head how much. It's like 650 or something. Nobody cares. 2016 ESCALADE. Okay. This is the CTS V series. Okay, it's kind of nice just to see it. I mean, it's a nice car and everything, but you'd probably be better off getting one of these instead of one of those Z06s, because those Z06s overheat like a mother. And the sad thing is, the mere fact that this holds my attention, that means that this is the best they got, and the Hellcat's still better than that. That sucks. It's a great car, though. Don't get me wrong. And here's the ATS-V. Look at that spoiler. Look at that spoiler. That is a nice spoiler. It's a pretty car. Interior is nice. There's a couple of things that I would have added to the interior that it doesn't have. But that doesn't change the fact it's a nice car. Look at that. XT5 3.6. Okay, what's the interior? Dark black interior. You gotta use the caramel, the light colors. If you really wanna sell these things, you gotta use the light colors. And this is gonna be their volume seller because crossovers are taking over the market. You know, everybody's got a crossover now. Most people aren't buying SUVs because they're too expensive, so everybody's pretty much got crossovers. It's basically a highly upgraded SRX, and they all have 3.6 liter V6 engines. The shame of the fact is that, you know, they don't have an XT5 V-series, because if they put some Brembo brakes on there, and they put a nice V8 or something in there, something fast, like a twin turbo something with 500 horsepower, if they had an engine like that, they could make this thing a monster and people would want it a little bit more than the regular one, you know, because a lot of these people got the money. Anybody who's spending, you know, if you option one of these cars out, it comes out to $69,000. You could go on the Cadillac option thing and you could check it yourself, but these things can actually come out to $69,000 option dollars, you know. But it's a badass car right here. Let's take just a couple pictures of it. And then I gotta go in there and register. Oh, these people really know how to set up. Oh boy, and then to have to drive the, CT6 to drive that on, it's these stupid letters, man. They gotta do something about these letters. Can't they just give the car a regular name like ESCALADE? I gotta think about the damn letters. All right, I'm gonna stop this video just so I can make a quick post for my Facebook Live account. About CT6 plug-in. It's probably just that XT5. Nobody reads the disclaimers.
Well, you still got like 6 hours of sleep.
Okay, so I signed in. And, you know, these people right here are checking out the CT6, which is funny that they didn't keep it outside so that you can look at it outside. But, the problem is, there's not enough engine. Here's the problem. In order to really excite people about something like this, you've got to have a ridiculous offering. You have to have like a lot of power, or you have to have something that this thing can do that nothing else can, or you have to have some kind of just excitement. I mean, the Hellcat has 707 horsepower. Everybody knows that because they advertise it. And the thing about it is, what exactly are they advertising about the CT6? The first ever CT6? Well, yeah, it's the first ever, but what difference does that make? All they gotta do is throw some Brembos on this son of a bitch, put a better suspension in it for sport mode handling. Problem is, this is the kind of car you don't drive fast. So, my only thing is, the older retirees want a V8. It doesn't matter how much power it has, it's just that psychologically they want one. And that's the reason why Mercedes continues to sell V8 cars, the S-Class. But the main selling point of this car is how big it is. use it as speakers. So they got like a billion piece speaker system. The pan array. I saw this already at the car show.
Hi there.
Would you like to hop in and have the
Sure. This one has the Panoray?
All right.
I had leased an XTS. I was looking at one of these because I saw it at the car show. Mm-hmm. And
only they didn't have the fully loaded one. Like, so I've never heard the actual speaker.
Okay.
XTS and S.R.T had them like right there.
Right. They've been integrated into the headrest.
This is a subwoofer?
You have two local frequency range units underneath the floorboard on both sides.
Oh, okay.
And then you can see those, the big long one displayed on the pillar back there, outside.
Cool.
So,
all right. That really long speaker is kept in the back.
I'll walk you through that out there. Redemption in you, watching them just buy it is some man's assault. There are 34 speakers. Left unspoken. If you start looking, you'll see them different places.
That option is like what, 25 or? That option if you get it in this car?
It comes in the Platinum Standard. If you're looking at the luxury or the premium luxury, I believe it's about a $3,700 option.
$3,700, okay. So, a 3.6 liter model with that, the moonroof, not really with the television, the 3.6 plus of that, how much with the sound system, with pretty much everything except those televisions. Standard wheels, non-platinum paint, because that's like $1,000 right there.
I'll let the library load. I can tell you what each level starts at. As far as building the packages and doing all that, that would be a different.
I could look at the configurator
later
on and I could build one.
This, the base model starts at 54.5, luxury 59.4, premium 64.6, and then your platinum, you have two levels of platinum at 84.5, and I believe the other one is 88.4, right? So this one is the fully loaded at that price point. So if you're looking at the Panoray system and wanting to add it to the premium luxury or the luxury, that's certainly an option, and it is $3,700 to do
okay.
that.
All right. Looks good. If it's not an XT5 we get next, I'd probably get one of these, because I'm wondering what the XT5 will get as far as this equipment, because the thing about it is the crossover gives us so much more space, especially in the back for like putting stuff in it. But and I know they're getting this mirror where you could, you know, the LCD mirror and everything. But I don't know, I just guess we wait and see. Because it's all leases anyway.
Right, XT5 will not have the Bose Panoray system. Because
Bose sat down with Cadillac to design this system exclusively for this car.
Right, okay.
So you'll be able to get a Bose sound system in the XT5, but it won't be the Panerai.
Okay. Love it. It looks nice. It's fantastic. It's so big. Yeah, and I know the back seats are big too. In fact, let me go back there.
Sure.
Yeah. Wow. How? Here's a question that I had for a while. How do you retract the television screens if you're a passenger? So the passenger can't do it themselves?
They will be able to with the remote.
Only with a remote, yeah. But there's no button.
Right.
There's no button. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, she has to reset the seat because, like, I put the seat, like, so far back. Does this thing have a spare? Does this have a spare? Nope, no spare. Well, okay, so this is the ATS-V, and once again, this is the XT5. So the problem is, Facebook, when you make a live video on Facebook, the problem ultimately is that it makes the video a 480p video. So,
how are you?
Pretty good.
I don't want to interrupt your voice over there.
Thank you. Yeah, we just got, we just got an SRX, and I would have gotten this, but the problem was this wasn't available the SRX. But they got them now.
You probably got a good deal, too.
Oh, yeah, because it was the end of the term.
Awesome. Good for you.
I would have just as easily gotten one of these, but it just wasn't available. So, I was just taking a look at it. This one's fully loaded?
This one is, I believe, a flat.
Oh, okay, this is a flat. Cool. What's gonna happen is at the end of that lease, this if it's not a CT6, we'll probably end up getting
awesome.
One of these anyway.
You're a Cadillac family. We love to hear that.
Well, we came out of the STS because what it is, I got.
I'm sorry.
Oh no! Don't worry about it. Oh, don't worry about it. Okay, so this is the platinum model. Now the problem that I have was, and I hate to complain, but my only thing is when you bring these cars and you're showing people these cars, you really need to get a lighter interior like the grays or something a little bit lighter just so you can show off the nicest colors that you got. And they
I'm
can keep
sorry
those inside.
You're being called on the radio there.
Oh, okay. No, it's all right cuz I know you guys are working and everything.
Well,
but
get you ready to have a fun couple hours here.
Perfect. But no, I was looking at the CT6, and we actually did see it, but it was just such a big car that we really didn't need something like that, because it's basically just one person driving it, so.
Yeah, it is a big sedan, and I mean, is it family with kids and everything?
No.
Oh, okay, so then, yeah, you just choose.
I got it for my mom. Her kids are grown.
Oh, you know. What a good son.
Yeah.
What is your name, by the way?
John.
John, what?
John.
John,
uh-huh.
I'm Rosemary. Pleasure to meet
Rosemary.
You, John.
How you doing?
Well, have fun today at the event. We're going to get, you're in the great group. We're going to get everybody going relatively soon. And
right, 15 minutes, right?
Yeah, we'll have some fun today. Thanks, John.
Sure. Okay, and this is their new shifter. And similar to what killed Anton Yelchin, it's a monostatic shifter. Monostatic means that no matter which way you push it, it's always going to return to the center. Now, to put this thing in reverse, you have to actually push up and then you have to pull to the side. Now,
I think the pull to the side motion to go into reverse is probably a good thing, because this way all the drive modes are on the same side and reverse takes extra effort to get to, which means that it's almost impossible to screw that up, you know, because poor Anton Yelchin, he put his thing in what he thought was park, and next thing you know, it's rolling over him. So that's not good. But other than that, I mean, this car, strangely enough, they put the touchpad in the CT6, but they don't have the touchpad here. So that means that now you gotta reach up and you gotta touch in order to get, you know, navigation and this, that, and other. And this car, unlike the other ones I've seen, has the heads-up display, which you can see right there. So that's the heads-up display. And other than that, you know, from what I've heard, this thing has slightly more leg space in the back than the SRX because they set the seat a little bit further back. And it's, I think it has like a slightly higher roof. But that is the XT5. All right, so we'll be driving this on the track a little bit later. I have plenty of battery power because I brought my Mophie, so I'm good. And this is the Beast ATS-V. Looks faster. It looks a lot faster than it actually is. I get all these people complaining about the things I say. They're like, oh yeah, well, some people don't want a 500 horsepower car to drive around in the street. Some people just want just enough to be able to drive, like, just to drive around the track. Yeah, but guess what, guys? Guess what? Guess what? The more power you put in the car, the easier it is to sell. So, your complaints when I said that the CTS-V was whack compared to the Hellcat, your complaints are null and void. Because the simple fact of the matter is, more power equals more sales. And it's all about sales. This is the CTS-V. This is the top echelon Cadillac. This is the best you can get. It's the best you can get. Vroom. And my car sounds better than this.
You need this car. Hmm. You need this car. You know that, right?
I'm sorry?
You need this car.
I have a Hellcat. Do you know what a Hellcat is?
I know what a
Hellcat is. What a Hellcat is. Okay.
It's not a CTS-V.
It's not a CTS-V. There are a couple of things that this car has that my car doesn't have, which I wish it did, but, you know, you can't. It's not perfect. Nothing's perfect.
No.
But it, you know, and then we're going to see all these things later over there. But, yeah, it's nice. It's really
nice.
It's nice. Yeah, the material's pretty good. The material's
pretty good.
Yeah, yeah.
This is pretty good. This is an amazing car. This is all hand-stitched.
Okay.
You're like, it's pretty good.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's cool, but I'll dust this thing on a track. Not on a track. I'll dust it in a straight line.
How much does the Hellcat have?
The only thing that this car has that my Hellcat didn't is this moonroof right here, which I need, because the problem is otherwise you end up looking under trying to look at the lights, because you're always going to be at the front of the light. Basically you're drag racing everybody in the street, so you're always going to end up right at the light. Uh-huh. So you end up having to look just like this to see stoplights. I need a moonroof, and a lot of the chargers didn't come with moonroof, so that's a problem. But
This car doesn't have all-wheel drive. No, the Hellcat. Does that come with all-wheel drive?
The Jeep is going to have it. Like, I have, the Jeep S.R.T. 2. Those come with all-wheel drive, and right now those are the only way you can get the Hemi engine, S.R.T. engine. You can only get it in a Jeep with all-wheel drive. I don't think that they're going to make the car with all-wheel drive, because most of these cars, rear-wheel drive is, that's the selling point, that they have all that
it's
power and all
those. It's a performance
vehicle. Yeah, but you gotta understand.
And also, when you have all-wheel drive on it, you're dropping this is already gonna get a gas guzzler tax.
Nobody cares. Nobody cares about how much.
I don't know, but also with all-wheel drive, it makes it heavy.
Have you ever driven a Nissan GTR? If you drive a Nissan GTR, all of those are. First of all, and I need you to understand something, because a lot of people complain.
Hold on. Say it again.
Nissan GTR. You have to sing for that car. You have to sing for that car. No, but here's the problem. All-wheel drive, like, if you look at any of these new cars, the Bugatti Veyron, the Bugatti Chiron, the Lamborghini Aventador, all of the Ferraris, everything has gone to all-wheel drive and automatic transmissions. CTSs, they used to offer that 5-speed manual, and I'm pretty sure they might still offer it, but the simple fact is, it's like all-wheel drive, automatic transmission and a lot of power, it makes it so that anybody can drive the car. So what you get is, like, you get these rappers and you get these people who normally don't even drive cars. Now they got a Lamborghini, and it's not impossible for them to drive. And they,
drive it.
You know, it's just a regular car that is really, really, really powerful that you can drive all year round. So when it really comes down to it, one of my problems with that Hellcat was the fact that you can't drive it in winter because the ice, the snow, if the roads get, like, too wet, you're risking your life.
Mm-hmm.
And I drove it, when I bought it, I drove it out of the city. And it was snowing outside. And the back of the car, like, the back of the car was, like, just totally skidding out. The thing about it is, once you get it on dry pavement, the thing's a monster. But if the Nissan GTR... Yeah, my car sounds awesome. This is an awesome car. But the problem is, it's not 707 horsepower.
Yeah, but when are you actually going to use that unless you're taking it on a track?
On the regular streets, through the regular neighborhoods.
What are you doing?
Speeding. Where do you live? Speeding violations. Right here. No. You rack up tickets. You rack up stoplight tickets. But the problem is, it just makes you love it. And I'm sure this is an awesome car. Because we've owned, like, what, two Cadillacs at this point. And, you know, I like Cadillacs. But the thing about it is, like, you know, the Hemi gives you so much more. It's like you get a V8 with, you know, so much more power.
I'll take it back to the company with all-wheel drive. I mean,
they're
not going to do it only because it's a performance vehicle and makes it heavy.
Yeah, but that's the problem, though.
We're racing these.
The trade-off. But you got to understand the trade-off.
Does the M series come in an all-wheel drive package?
Those new AMGs and those new, I don't know if the BMW does, but the new AMGs are all-wheel drive. The new AMGs, they understand that in order to sell this and make it an all-year driver, they have all-wheel drive in just about all their cars. All of them have learned from Nissan GTR. Have you driven the GTR?
Yes.
Have you driven it? So you know what I'm saying.
I work for a lot of manufacturers, but yeah.
You know what I'm saying.
I've driven the GTR. I do work for Nissan. I work for Genesis, which is a new subsidiary of Hyundai.
It's a nice car.
It's a nice vehicle,
being sold at a reasonable price. I drove that R-Spec. I wasn't impressed by the R-Spec because it looked like they were trying to match S.R.T. performance. They didn't come anywhere near.
Mm-hmm.
But see, these guys want to hear it. I gotta say, this is an awesome car. It's really awesome. But it's just that, I got more. I'm sorry, it's just that time.
All right.
Your legs are okay, right?
No, I hope this one works.
Yeah, right. No, I think we should be okay. It's too bad the AC doesn't.
Yeah, this is low. Can we adjust it?
What?
Okay, so the Cadillac Enhanced Night Vision Demo. The first ever Cadillac CT6 features the industry's most advanced night vision safety technology. 69% of all pedestrian fatalities occur at night.
Feel it.
In this demonstration, you will see how the Enhanced Night Vision system can detect pedestrians and animals. Typical nighttime driving scene. As you drive down a rural road, the glare from oncoming headlights can blind even the best eyes. You cannot see past the glare to what might be standing directly in front of your vehicle. If a pedestrian were to come into your path, you wouldn't see him until it was too late to react. With the enhanced night vision system, you can see that a pedestrian is dangerously close to the path of your vehicle. He is highlighted in yellow because the system has classified him as a pedestrian. If the vehicle were in motion, you would get an alert in the cluster, the head-up display, and the seat, letting you know a pedestrian is in your path. Studies have shown that the risk for fatal pedestrian accidents is almost 4 times greater at night than during the day. Each year, over 100,000 pedestrians are killed worldwide. The enhanced night vision system in the CT6 can see through smoke and fog. You can see that fog makes visibility out of the windshield even worse, but it doesn't affect our thermal image at all. Without the detection from the enhanced night vision system, that pedestrian would remain invisible until they were shockingly close to the front of your car. With our system, you get all of that added warning so you can safely slow your vehicle before a collision takes place. Again, we have a low visibility situation where you can't see much out of the windshield, but you get a perfect detection of the deer. The deer is highlighted in orange since the system has classified him as an animal. If the vehicle were in motion, you would be getting alerts letting you know that there is a deer in your path or predicted to come into your path. As the fog dissipates, you might be able to see the deer. In this demonstration, the deer is only 40 feet away. In your new CT6 with enhanced night vision, you would begin receiving alerts when the deer is over 300 feet away. The enhanced night vision system is looking much farther than your headlights can illuminate. By the time a deer comes into your headlights, it is often too late to react. Swerving to avoid an animal can make a bad situation even worse. With this system, you get an advanced warning to the instrument cluster, the head-up display, and the seat so you can avoid the collision in the first place. Enhanced night vision is standard on the Platinum Trim CT6 and available as an option with the Driver Assist Package on the Premium Luxury Trim Offer.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's cool.
It's a nice system.
Little white spots and you go, wow, what is that? It's a bunch of birds sleeping in a tree. So we're going to tell you a little bit about the night vision technology. What you experienced was Cadillac's enhanced night vision. So you saw that you can see through smoke and fog and you can detect animals and pedestrians. The infrared camera is mounted in the front grille. So this is a live image. As you can see there, the camera is mounted right there. The reason it's mounted right there is infrared doesn't see through glass. So if I hold up this picture frame, you can see through it, but if I hold it up to the camera, it's opaque. You can't see through it. But if I put my hand on this piece of glass for just a couple seconds, then I hold it up,
the heat.
You see that I left a heat print on the glass, and that's what it's detecting, temperature differences. If you look back here, you can see the word enhanced night vision. So those are the letters on the back panel back there. And so the sun is beating down on those letters and it's heating them up. The white background is a different temperature.
Oh,
so what's not white, what's cold is black. So if I held up, actually glass is also, since it doesn't see through glass will come up as black, kind of like cold items. Infrared technology doesn't see through walls, it doesn't see through glass, but there are some materials that it can see through. So if I hold this up, you can't see through it. But if I put it in front of the camera, you'll see that it's transmissive. But if I fold this material in half, you'll see that it doesn't transmit through it. So it's got to be very, very thin in order for infrared energy to transmit through it, or it's got to be a good conductor of thermodynamics. So when you're cooking, you put a frying pan over the fire, that frying pan heats up really well. So metals are good conductors. So the optics in that camera are actually made out of metal. So you physically can't see through them, but the metal, the heat energy that we're putting out flows right through those optics, and that's what we make a video image out of.
Quick question. Yes. Does this system, do you have to clean it depending upon rain or snow or?
So the way Cadillac implemented it is there's actually a water jet, and that water jet is actually right on the side there.
Oh.
So when you wash your windshields and you put your water sprays on, it'll actually do high pressure water sprays. So if you're driving, especially in Florida where it's nice bugs that pile onto the front, you'll still be able to see. Because if I cover half of that window, you can see that there's still enough contrast there that you can still detect pedestrians and animals. But when it washes off those bugs, the performance comes back.
And of course, we have water
at
every station.
Oh, sounds good.
And this is Sonia.
Hi.
It's a nice color.
So, you know, I'm going to bring up a couple scenarios for you. You know, on the highway, you know, think of any, you know, it's going to pick up larger animals. So think of deer, cow, moose, no rabbits, but, you know, think of, you know, people that are on the side of the road changing their tire. You know, and most people drive the same at night as they do during the day, but you can't see what you can't see during the day. So that's what night vision is designed to do. It's a preventative alert system. It's not going to do the braking for you, but it's going to ahead and alert you. It's going to detect, and it's going to go ahead and alert you. The visual is always going to be your standard, and it will show you a little bit of some indications on your head-up display. So let's have everybody sit inside the driver's seat. We'll just do a rotation. There's that vehicle right there. Just sit for a minute or two.
Power over there. Yeah, my mom's part of a sorority. Her Delta Sigma Theta is named by colors off this. Yeah. What is it? Is that? Oh, yeah. And this car is like huge, like. All right, there we go.
Got it?
Yeah, thank you. Out for the deer. This has a heads-up display. Can you see it?
Baked into it all the best features of those cars and mitigated a lot of their compromises, okay? And you're going to experience that today. All these ATS-Vs are powered by a twin turbocharged 3.6 liter six cylinder motor. It produces 464 brake horsepower and 445 pound feet of torque. It is married to an 8-speed electronic gearbox. We do make a 6-speed manual. All the cars on the track are 8-speeds. There is a 6-speed manual right there that can be looked at. So if you want to see what a clutch pedal actually looks like in the real world, have a chance to glance at it there. It will do 0 to 60 in 3.8 seconds. Okay? Other than the McLaren F1, prior to about 1998, there wasn't a supercar in the world that could do 0 to 60 that quickly. So this is a supercar in terms of its performance. At full chat, it will do 189 miles per hour. You won't drive that fast today, and if you do, they probably won't ask me back tomorrow, so please don't do that. I've driven it about 170, and it clearly still had legs on it, so I believe that figure completely. What's going to happen today is I'll take five of you at a time, okay? You'll have a dedicated racing instructor with you in the vehicle. I'm no more important than they are. It's just my turn to talk today, so go ahead and listen to what they have to tell you. When you get in the car, they will direct you to roll toward the start line here, okay? You'll wait there until they give you the green light to go, the thumbs up. When they do, I want you to mash down the throttle in furious anger, okay? I want you to put your foot down as hard as you possibly can. You're going to race down the acceleration run until you cross the finish line. The finish line is clearly marked by orange cones, both upright and laying on their side. We call them pointer cones on a racetrack. There's also an A-frame sign on either side. A-frame is, see the drive course rule sign? That is an A-frame sign. It doesn't say drive course rules, it says finish down there. Okay, when you cross the finish line, let off the throttle, okay? Hard on the brakes, okay? These are Brembo brakes. They are 6-piston front, 4-piston rear. They will rip your face off. And I want you to feel that, okay? That's my idea here.
I like how he's talking to me as if I don't have a vocab.
And I want you to feel how stable the vehicle is under incredible braking, okay? That's the thing. So I want you to hold the wheel firmly, but don't white knuckle it, okay? Let the car talk to you a little bit, okay? When you go on a date, you let the girl or the guy talk a little bit more, right? So let the car talk to you a little bit. I want you to feel how stable it is. Once you get on the brakes hard, you will notice there are some cones that you approach that will funnel you into a narrower area that's designed to give you a visual representation of I need to slow the car down now. There's also two signs where they say shutdown area. I don't want you to shut the car off, but I want you to get off at speed. Now, once you're through those cones, you're going about 30 miles an hour. 30 miles an hour is a fairly safe speed to travel the return route. About midway through is a stop sign. Please honor that stop sign. We have cross traffic there occasionally, and we're watching for it, and our coaches are watching for it, but I also need your eyes on paying attention, stopping something unsafe from potentially happening. You'll then roll the vehicle back in the staging area, hop out of the vehicle, next driver will get in. A couple safety rules here. Safety's a little bit boring, but I want to talk about it for a second. Seat belts on at all times. It sounds lame, but I'm telling you, I've been doing this job for a long time, and people routinely forget to put seat belts on when the car is not belonging to them. Please follow your instructor directions at all times. Please obey the signage. The signs are simple. Start, stop, slow. You guys got this. When you're in the staging area, which is where the cars are parked now, I want you to operate the vehicle at walking speed. People are getting in and out of cars. Somebody's not paying attention, okay? So I want to make sure that you're not running somebody over, even if it's somebody that you would like to run over.
Please.
Yeah, I've experienced no problem. Somebody's biggest
Huh? It's almost there. I think this is the manual. That one's the manual. They said, yeah, if you want to get a good look of what a clutch pedal looks like. See now why everybody is raving about this car. Like, I have friends in the automotive journalism world, and they've been raving about it. My only problem, obviously, is the size.
Yeah.
But, yeah, they've been really constantly raving about this car.
Yeah.
All this car needs is about maybe a $599 per month lease.
Mm-hmm.
All good.
Well, I'm sure if you don't get the it loaded to the max, you can probably drop that price point.
Well, me part, I would just want the heads-up display. I could do it out, but I just want the moonroof and the heated cooled seats. But these, the Recaros only come heated. They don't come with cool.
They don't come cool, right?
There we go.
and that track over there is for driving anything.
Yeah.
That's nice. Yeah, that's nice. I like that. That is nice. Okay. Thank you. You've been a big help.
You're
that
welcome.
Feels really good. So when I go
experience these three features: front pedestrian braking, forward automatic braking, and rear cross traffic alert. Now, having shown those three features and talking about them, I want to follow up with, let's keep in mind that there are no driving assists that are intended to replace responsible driving, right? We all know that, okay, we all get it. And then the next thing is, don't try this at home, okay? And sometimes that goes in one ear and out the other. I'm gonna do this anyway, because I'm really good at this stuff. When it comes to these two features, please do not try this at home, because these systems have to see certain parameters before they'll take action. And if you don't fulfill all of those parameters, the system will not take action. Park the car perpendicular. Really neat feature. We are going to demonstrate the parallel version for you. You can see all the orange barriers way out there. So we're going to do that demonstration for you. So very simply, on this course, you're going to ride as a passenger, we demo. Over here, you ride as a passenger initially, and then you have the opportunity to drive this if you choose. I think we might probably get one or two people through on the driving end in each round. All right, so with that, we're going to go ahead to the courses. Please, no food or drinks in the car. Just leave them sit somewhere here. You can retrieve it when you get back.
So the automatic park assist does not need to... you don't need to stop to do this. I'm just going to kind of slow everything down so you can see what I'm doing. The only requirement is that you're under 18 miles an hour.
Mm-hmm.
Other than that, you can just hit this button here. The automatic park assist turns on. It says up here searching for a spot. Wow. The way it works is there's two cameras up in this unit here, one to the right, one to the left. It's looking on both sides of the road. What it's doing is it's taking a series of pictures. I don't know. It's something crazy like 1,000 per second or something. Jesus. It may even be more than that. But it's taking pictures constantly and looking for a spot. What it's doing is it's looking for vehicles and curbs.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have any of that.
Right.
So just to help this system out, I'm going to get real close to the barriers, but you can drive. You don't have to drive as close as I am. The second thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on the blinker, and that just helps it look in the direction that the blinker is on.
Okay. Okay.
So we have time for one of you to try this. So whoever does it, make sure that you keep a nice, consistent speed. A lot of people want to come here and break a bunch.
Yeah.
Keep the speed consistent.
I usually just throw on 18 cool miles suits an hour. And that's it.
Every time you hear it beep, that's letting me know that there's a spot available.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So there's another one. I'm going to pull down to this one. Okay. Remember, it's always past the spot.
Right.
So it said stop up here, and it just flashed off. Now it's going to say back up slowly.
Keep it in reverse.
Put it in reverse.
Take everything. Take the throttle.
I'm going to control the brake.
Oh, the braking. Okay.
Now, do you have to? The Cadillac tells you yes, you have to.
I've found through certain ways that the rear brake assist will also chime in, but that's a separate system entirely, so it's not intended to brake.
Especially at night. Like you're doing in a tight space at night.
I only see the commercials. It's like, yes, it's cool.
I never thought it would be.
So I get the question all the time, like, well, how does it know? There's enough space for it, it will put it in. I've seen it park, I'm exaggerating, probably like that much on each side.
Wow.
So if it has enough space to roll in, it'll do it.
Wow.
And it won't beep unless it has enough space, so it's not like you have to sit there and figure it out.
Yeah.
So if it doesn't have enough space, it won't do it.
Come on, baby. Come on. All right, I'm doing it. Did it.
That is cool.
Would anyone like to try it?
You want to try it, Mike?
Oh, you can. You can. I'll watch you with this one. Maybe I'll hit it later. Or the XT5 or something.
Thinks you're in a parking lot situation or a garage or whatever, it turns on the front display when you drive, the rear display when you're in reverse. And you'll always have the around view.
Now, we're in a situation where you're on a crowded boulevard,
mm-hmm.
and you need to make a parking, you know, you don't have time to mess around. How How fast is this system up?
Quick. Okay. Turn your signal. Make it easy. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going.
What about this one?
It'll beep.
Oh, keep going.
Keep going. Stop. Reverse. Hands up a bit. Cross your arms. I don't trust you.
Cross your arms.
First time I did it, I go to grab it a couple times. So yeah, just let it go. And watch the arrow. The arrow fills up with blue. Once it's blue, it'll turn into a stop sign. Brake.
Wow, Jesus.
There's your automatic brake assist.
All right. Gotcha.
It's not intended to chime in, nope. But it will sometimes. Yeah.
Okay.
Or it may, I should say.
Did he brake or did it?
That was the car.
That was the car.
But again, guys, it's not designed to do that. That's a separate technology that chimes in. But it's not intended to do that. If you read the owner's manual, it says to you're controlling the brake while parallel parking.
Okay.
Yeah. Guys, it also perpendicular parks. I don't know if I mentioned that.
Yes, the gentleman.
So yeah, if you're in this lot for a game, you drive by, it'll recognize a spot for that, and it'll back you in.
And I'm assuming it can only do that if there's lines.
No, lines aren't it. It's
the
vehicles
cars.
And curves.
Okay, vehicles and curves.
Yeah,
okay.
If there's no cars, you wouldn't need the help. Okay. Is their idea.
Good point.
Well, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead and put it in drive.
Okay. And it takes it off automatically.
Yeah, one more gear. But you have your surround view, so when you pull out, just watch this. As long as this car is clear, you're clear. And it actually gives you a little bit.
You have to lift up and then pull out for something.
Oh, like this?
Yeah, it's like a hook.
Oh, that is really cool. This is just a really cool ride.
You see this?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
So you know you got clearance. That is great. That's amazing.
This one's the 3.0 or the 3.6?
This is the 3.0 twin turbo.
Okay.
If you're looking for power, this is the one you want to get.
This is the one you get. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're going to loop it around to the left. And crank it. This also has all-wheel steer. It's all-wheel drive, but it also has all-wheel steer. So when you crank that wheel at a slow speed, front tires turn to the right, rear tires turn to the left to help the car rotate.
Mm-hmm.
At a higher speed, both wheels will turn at the same direction to help the car. So like if you're making an evasive maneuver, changing lanes or whatever, instead of a lot of weight transfer, it has more of like a crab walk.
I got you. Yeah. I got you.
Cool. Thanks, bro. Cool. Thank you,
thank
guys.
You. All
right. Yeah.
The seat adjustments. First off, if you can hear me, put your window down and give me a thumbs up just to make sure that I've got good radio comms with everybody. Okay. I got you in the back. How about the Escalade in the back? Can you give me a thumbs up if you can hear me? Escalade, a big car in the back. Give me a thumbs up if you can hear me.
How about that? Is that cool or what?
Yeah.
I can see a lot better out with that.
Yeah.
I'm good. I'm using that.
When I drove this car first, there was a guy behind me who had an accident. And because of the camera, you're staring like right into the crack in the front of his engine block.
All right, folks, we're getting ready to rock. We're gonna let Group One roll out ahead of us, so we don't have too much of a Cadillac presence on the street and just overwhelm the folks. Maybe while you're waiting for this few seconds, you can find your favorite radio station.
Heads up here.
Adjust your.
Don't worry about it, James. Don't worry.
I'm going to be talking to you around the streets, and in case you get lost, don't worry, we'll bring you back here. All right, XT5 drivers, that is a new car in our lineup. It has an electronic shifter. In order to put it in gear, you need to squeeze the button on the side of the shifter and pull it down into drive. So go ahead and do that now, and we'll slow roll out.
through the parking lot, staying away from the orange cones. James, I need you to do me a favor. Stop, grab two cold waters, and give them to the gate guy, please. Thanks very much. All right, gang, we're going to come down here to the gate. The gate guard is going to let us out. We're going to make an immediate right out onto the street.
How you liking it?
I like it. It's kind of smooth, you know? Good driver's car.
Now, you said you had a Fusion. You got a Titanium?
No, I got a Focus.
Oh, Focus.
Yeah.
All right, a little smaller than I'd like, but... We've got three large speed bumps here in front of the museum. The first one's marked with the yellow sign, but the second one here is not marked. It's made with cobblestone, so... don't let it catch you by surprise.
Focus, but I need the manual, so I couldn't get a titanium.
Oh, you have a manual. 6 speed or 5?
Just 5.
5.
Park road kind of resembles a 2-lane country road. There's very light traffic.
Well, they got that ATS-V for you. The manual. Or Challenger.
Challenger works too.
I think you want that Challenger.
Yeah, I do. I actually, probably my third car was a 73 Cuda.
Ooh. You know they're bringing the Cuda back. I don't know. I think it's going to be like a year.
But just the, when they came out with the Challenge, I was like, oh, the shape. It looks so much like that car.
Monsters.
Like, whoa. I had orange and black, too.
Yeah, I'm on my...
My friends called it the Halloween car.
The Halloween car?
It was black and orange.
Yeah, word of advice, if you choose to go for the, like, if you choose to go for the best one, like the S.R.T. with the manual, don't drive in second gear because you will destroy that gear. Because a lot of people, they abuse it, and with the Hellcats, they're ripping those gears apart, like, just destroying them.
Just kind of. Like, but yeah, second gear and go right into third.
What color would you get, green?
Yeah, it's guy up the street from me used to have the AAR green.
All right, gang, great job sticking together and feeling the ride here. We're going to be turning right at the next stop sign. This is a particularly narrow driveway as we come into the park, so watch yourself as you go through these high curves.
Yeah, that'd be a good look for you.
Alright gang, we're going to be pulling to the right here into the parking lot. This is where we're going to affect our first driver change. So, driver change and car change. Alright? Remember, you're going to be rotating to the car in front. Unless you're, of course, in the very front car, then you go to the back.
That's the XT5. You could go for that.
You want to drive that one?
No, I'm going to sit in the back probably.
Like it?
Yeah. Of course. Well, the XT5, this is new. So, I'll sit in the back. I'll sit in the back. Thanks. You and your dad, I don't want you and your dad enjoy it. So if you don't mind, just move up, yeah. How are you liking it?
This one, yeah, you got
it. Oh, thanks.
All right.
Want to throw it up?
Well, yeah, if you're okay. Thank you. Yeah, no, this is a beautiful interior.
Yeah, I like the light color. Definitely.
Yeah.
It's like my
makes it not as hot as...
See, as long as you get the ultra, when you get these panoramic roofs and you get like the nice bright colors, it makes the inside look a lot bigger than, you know, it's like going to an art gallery. You got to get that light in.
Alright guys, new car to you. Go ahead and make sure that you're comfortable. You know the seat adjustments. Some of the cars have the seat adjustments on the doors. Take a minute to adjust the mirrors. Find that favorite radio station if you need it. And let's get ready to rock. Again, if you're new to the XT5, you gotta squeeze the button on the side of the shifter in order to get it into gear. All right, if everybody's ready, we will roll out. Slow roll off the curb as we come back into alignment here.
Pedals are too high or something.
I don't know if this one has power pedals.
Said easy off the curb, but I wanted to see what the clearance was like.
Yep. And as we roll outside of the parking lot here at the stop sign, we're going to be turning right again.
How do you feel about this one?
Nice. I like it.
Which one do you like better?
I'm not a car fanatic, so I don't really know.
You don't care, you don't care. How do you feel about Tesla?
All right, we're turning
Tesla?
Right.
How do you feel about
it? Yeah. And going over the little bridge back to the next stoplight, to which we'll turn right again.
They have, it's like we've got so many choices now. Well, I drove that Model X recently.
Okay. So here's the SUV. Turning into traffic.
Liked it.
And again, just want to let you know that it's very easy to find your way back to City Field from here. It's all right turns. Yeah, so should you get separated from the Cadillac group, just keep making right turns from where you are right now. Getting onto the Central Expressway, make a right turn, and then you'll be getting off at the City Field exit, which is 9E. But again, I'll talk you through it.
Oh, where are you guys at now?
Centerport, Long Island.
Where?
Centerport?
How
yeah,
far
right,
is
we're right next to Huntington.
Okay, just yeah, so it's like 40 miles, 45.
Oh, okay.
Where are you?
Queens. Yeah, the border of Valley Stream. I was lucky enough to be able to get a house before the prices shot up. So, you know, I work in the city. Manhattan, Queens. Yeah, some people, you know, some of my friends are leaving, going to other states and everything. I refuse.
Right, and then right again.
What's your name?
Oh, John.
All right, we got
John?
John.
I'm Tom.
It's James. James. All right, Tom and James.
So we'll get up here onto the expressway.
Yes.
Stay in the right lane. Everybody will do just fine. By yourself? Yep, everybody else made it through. Perfect, I'll adjust my speed.
Gay fans?
I am anyway.
Yeah.
I forced them. He's growing up.
42,
with it, so,
huh? Channel 42?
42.
And this is a perfect opportunity for your car.
You guys don't like metal at all?
You know, I liked it when I was younger. His age, and you know, it drove my parents crazy, but well, pretty much listen to most people.
So, no five finger death punch, no Metallica, no none of that, none of that.
Metallica.
Five Finger Death Punch seems like they're trying to be a lot like them in style, but
yeah, back in the 80s I got a lot of
yeah, that XTS was a
little
yeah,
he's here at the stop sign for a few extra
like,
seconds
oh, man,
to make sure that all of my little ducks are in a row. Everybody looks good, so let's go ahead onto the surface street. Once onto the surface street, immediately make it into the left lane. As we get ready to go back into gate number 4 at City Field. This will be a left-hand lane, left turn rather, into the parking lot. All
for another day.
Hey.
We really appreciate your coming out today. We know you have lots of choices when you fly, and we appreciate you flying Cadillac Airlines.
All right, that was fun.
We will be looping back around, putting the cars right back where we found them. When you come to a full and complete stop, put it in park and leave the engine running for me so it's nice and cool for the next guy. Don't forget your personal items, your cell phones, your sunglasses, hats, bags, things like that. Anything that I find, I get to sell on eBay.
I'm sorry?
No wallets back there?
Wallets?
Yeah, we found a wallet in the last guy.
Oh, you found a wallet. All right, guys.
Yeah, there you go.
It says hold shift or button to shift. Yeah, you're in park.
Yeah, I don't think it won't even roll forward.
You heard what happened to Anton Yelchin, Chekhov from Star Trek?
Yeah.
No, they're changing.
These kind of things, right?
Yeah. Monostatic shifts. Okay, that was fun. Cadillac Airlines. XT5 it was. That's the Cadillac XT5. And the last video was the CT6. I just got finished driving a CTS 3.6 liter, and I'm going to drive the CTS 2.0 if they have one, because I'm not really sure. I think that might be the CTS 2.0 right there. But, it's exactly what most of you already know. It's a great interior. It's a good engine. It's fun to drive. I like the color choices. But, this is a really, really good event, and they're having this exact same event tomorrow. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring some of my family members who actually own Cadillacs or Lincolns to get them to take a look and see how they like these cars. And basically the way it works is they have an 8:30 session, they have a 12:30 session, and then they have a 3:30 session. So I came here for the 8:30 session. I got here nice and early. Everything worked out perfectly. And the next session is probably already started. Well, no, it hasn't. It's 10:59. So the next session starts at 12:30. And then after that, there's the 3:30. And that's it. So the ATS-V coupe
and the ATS-V, I could never personally consider for myself because they're just too small. The CTS-V is a car I could consider, but the thing about it is at $90,000, there's other options like, obviously, you know, Hellcats, and then there's also a Tesla Model S, but you have lots of choices, and that's the important thing, the fact that there's so many choices. If you, you know, for whatever you want, whatever you feel like getting, there's so many choices. That's an ATS coupe right there, 3.6. This is an ATS coupe. Okay, and I see a Sun. That's the 2.0 ATS. This is the ATS 3.6. This is the CTS, I believe. And so that's basically my coverage of the Truth and Dare event. And you know, as a Cadillac owner, I really like these events that they're doing, and it's a good thing that they're showing people how powerful these cars are, especially the ATS-V. And you know, it's a really good event, and I'm glad that they're giving people the chance to be able to drive the XT5 and being able to drive the CT6, and I'm glad people are able to drive the Escalade, because a lot of people want to own an Escalade, but you know, that damn thing is nearly $100,000. It's like buying an S-Class. But you know, having the ability to actually test drive these things is something that more car companies need to be doing, especially if they know that they're you know, they need to improve their sales. Because the thing about it is, when people actually get to drive these cars, it's more than just speculation. They actually get to see how they handle in regular real-world situations. And I really like the street drive that they allowed us to do. That's a really good thing. And yeah, as you can see, they have speed bumps for the course, because they want you to see how it handles over the speed bumps and everything. I recommend a 4-year lease or 3-year lease, so long as you know that there's no new technology coming. But that's basically it. It was a really good event, and I'm going to be back tomorrow. After I post up this video, I'll probably be back tomorrow, and I'll be playing second fiddle either to my mom or someone else, maybe an uncle or whatever, or girlfriend, whatever, whoever wants to drive, because some people don't even want to come to these things. But I'm going to try to be enthusiastic. I'm going to try to get a couple people come and take a look at the product. Very good vehicles. Cadillac has definitely stepped their game up. Very, very impressed.